Hey, SciShow viewers, it's John Green. So over on Crash Course, we just launched a limited series podcast called The Universe, where the astrophysicist Dr. Katie Mack walks me through the history of the entire universe, including the parts that haven't been written yet. Take a look.
So today we are going to pause from our cosmic timeline, where we've been going through the first seconds and then millions of years of the universe. And we're going to take a quick gander at something I have genuinely, deeply no understanding of, which is black holes. I mean, you are painting onto a blank canvas right now, Dr. Mack.
Okay. There's a lot of weird stuff about black holes.
So how come they don't suck in everything?
Well, because not everything is already falling toward the black hole.
Oh, okay. So it's only things that are already falling toward the black hole. It doesn't, like, expand infinitely.
Yeah. It can't, like, reach out to distant things.
But if I got near it.
If you get near it, it's a problem.
If I got in a spaceship and got close to it, that would be a big problem.
Yeah. The way that gravity works, like, let's say that you're in, like, I don't know, like a giant cloud of gas or something. And there's a whole lot of density at the center, but you're kind of toward the outer edges. You're going to feel the gravity of everything within, like, closer to the center than you. Like, you can draw like a sphere and you're at the edge of that sphere and everything close to the center, you're going to feel the gravity of that. If you get closer and closer to the middle, you're just going to feel the gravity of the stuff interior to you. And so if you get really far away from that gas cloud, you're going to feel as much gravity as if all of that whole gas cloud was compressed to a single point in the center. The amount of gravity that you'll feel is the same because you're still just feeling all of the gravity of the stuff interior to you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So what matters is how close you are to the center of, like, where the matter is concentrated.
Okay, so if you made the Earth half the size that it is now, with the same density.
Well, the same amount of stuff.
Same overall amount of stuff, but in half the size, I would still walk around the Earth feeling the way I feel now.
Let me put it this way. If you could keep the outer layer of the Earth, but compress all of the rest of it into a smaller space, you would feel the same.
Right. Okay.
But if you actually compressed it all and then you were close, you were down there, right? If you compress everything and you were down there, then you would feel more gravity because you're closer to the center of where all that gravity is.
Okay.
However you redistribute the matter, as long as it's still kind of interior to you in that sort of sphere, It's how far you are from, I mean, to first approximation, there are things that can change, but, like, you know, how far away you are from the center. So, like, a neutron star, a white dwarf, you know, the sun, they can all be around the same mass, like around a solar mass. There's some variation. Neutron stars have to be a little bit more massive, but, you know, they can be in the same sort of range of masses, but it would kill you a lot more to be, the gravity would kill you a lot more to be on a white dwarf or a neutron star than it would on something as massive as the sun, because all that matter is much more compact. You'd be closer to the center of it. So it's the compactness of matter that really affects how much gravity you feel.
And because these black holes are really, really, really compact,
then if you get close enough to them, you get really screwed up. But if you're far away, like, if you have a black hole that has the same mass as the sun, if you're far enough away from it, you don't feel any different gravitationally than if it were just a regular star. So the same reason the sun is not sucking up all the matter around it, the black hole won't either.
Got it. Okay. But if you get close enough, it will.
If you get close enough, then things get really weird.
There's a lot more where that came from. The Universe is available now, both on the Crash Course YouTube channel and wherever you get your podcasts.